अतिक विजय नाकरा नाम ही भजन है नहीं? What a big fish.
Dude, in the interview, keep things cool because we are the small fish.
इतना भी small नहीं है ये. कार्तिक. Oh, I think I'm looking good.
M&M's?
I love them all.
Please have a seat. Please have a seat.
To be here at this big table in front of a big man, that's something.
It's really good to meet you, Mr. Nathra. Yeah.
Thank you so much, and a real pleasure to have you.
Where's the XUV500? Please, may I ask?
No. Wait, hang on. I mean, there's ought to be a better way to start this.
You are the CEO of Mahindra and Mahindra Auto Division. Tell me, do you feel like an Amitabh Bachchan?
You know, that's an interesting question. Firstly, thanks for comparing me to someone like Big B Amitabh Bachchan. But I'm just kind of wondering whether I'm the Vijay Dinanath Chauhan or am I the Amitabh Bachchan of Coolie, looking at trying to run this business in the midst of all the pandemic. On your question, my friend, who asked that question?
Where is the XUV500? The whole world.
Sabse pehle for you. सबर का फल मीठा होता है
सर ऐसा ना हो जाए कि डायबिटीज हो जाए मोस्ट रिसेंटली सुयश सावरे मैसेज मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम एंड ही इज वेटिंग टू बाय इट बिकॉज वी आस्क्ड हिम टू वेट एंड ही इज लाइक और कितना
एंड जस्ट टू आंसर दैट क्वेश्चन सुयश द आंसर फॉर यू द न्यू एक्सयूवी इज स्केड्यूल्ड टू बी लॉन्च बिटवीन क्वार्टर टू एंड क्वार्टर थ्री ऑफ दिस कैलेंडर ईयर
बिटवीन क्वार्टर टू टू क्वार्टर थ्री सो जुलाई
अंदाज अपना अपना
विजय महिंद्रा इज pride of the nation one can say that it gave some of the best SUVs to the country even before others were making SUVs it's very quick to react to the market requirement the market demand what's the secret sauce at Mahindra that really makes it such a large company
just FYI I've been with this company now 25 years so I've been a part of the growth journey over a period of time we've been clear that the objective at Mahindra Mahindra auto business is to create products that are differentiated products that are not run-of-the-mill, products with unmissable presence, and to lead what we do in the SUV space.
Mahindra was synonymous with SUV, but today everybody is an SUV maker. I mean, isn't it risky? Because considering that Mahindra does not make anything else other than SUV.
It always does go back to what is an SUV, right? And while the lines that define what is an SUV today are becoming blurred, at Mahindra we are very clear the SUVs we make will be unmissable presence and that will be SUVs that will differentiate themselves from the so to say car derived or car derivatives of SUVs. It's not just about ruggedness. 10 years ago I would say tough and ruggedness were the keywords but okay. Today that's not necessarily the keyword. We want to take the DNA forward of being tough but we have to make ourselves relevant to the audience today who considers SUVs. The new generation Thar that we've got, whether you look at design, whether you look at the engineering, whether you look at the platform, suspension, the gasoline, diesel, manual, auto, soft top, hard top,
five door.
It's a three door at the moment. The interesting part is one of your colleagues from the auto fraternity who just put out a fantastic article of comparing the Thar to the Sonet. Why buy a product like Sonet when you can buy a product like Thar which gives you a very very differentiated
Sonet
SUV
has two more doors.
I recently had a child, you know, my wife keeps complaining that she needs a bigger SUV. Just like people have been waiting on XUV500, I've been waiting on a five-door Thar.
Very interesting way of trying to, you know, get it's that answer from
consumers
me.
Consumers talking to you.
Sure. Let's say the people in the age group of 25 to 35, 40 who are in their first jobs or just got married or even if they have younger children. This is their age and time where they would want to experience a vehicle like the Thar rather than buy a wannabe SUV.
KUV, how would you justify that?
Yeah, and I don't think there's anything wrong in me admitting that when the category was expanding and growing and like we spoke about everybody was coming in with their so to say SUVs, we obviously wanted to get a fair share of the pie of the entry level SUVs. That segment is primarily more the people who buy vehicles for value for money, mileage, more than the experience and thrill and pleasure of driving an SUV. So we are clear that you know, that's probably not the strategy for us.
So no hatchbacks from Mahindra.
It's like never say never, but we are clear we are not going to make sedans.
I'm going to push you here. Mm-hmm. Lots of products in the pipeline, as we've seen. The Thar was the first. How many can we expect in this year?
Yeah. Look, there he is, you know, tapping his answers. I'm getting the answers. In terms of sequence, it's pretty clear. The Thar was the first. The W601, which is the new XUV, is the second. And then the Z101, which is the Scorpio, is the third one. I don't think it's fair for me to talk about the timing of the Z101.
So it's going to be a dhamaka Diwali.
So we've got, yeah, three big blockbusters, one after the other. One done, two more to come.
You know, the funny thing with the Thar has been, when we did the story, we said, you know, now you'll be able to convince your wife that you can have the Thar as a family.
Yes, we did that story. I was wearing the same shirt in that story. In case you want to look out for that story, you'll just find the same guy wearing the same shirt and should be easier.
The interesting thing has been that a lot of friends have called in and said, what do you mean convince the wife? The wife wants it.
Absolutely.
Well, it looks macho and women like macho people.
Mahindra has been the first mover in EVs, wouldn't
you
say?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Yes, pioneers.
I mean, we've had the E2O for so long, but we've been looking for something that people would actually go and buy as an everyday car.
You know, the thing is, everybody tends to look at the EV space only in the personal mobility domain. Highest level of adoption of EVs right now is in mass mobility, goods and people. So whether you look at our Treo Load, the Treo Zor, which is the first three-wheeled electric lithium-ion three-wheeled product that we've launched, unprecedented demand again. Whether you look at the C110, which is the Atom that we are launched at the auto show, and that's the next product that we are again going to launch in that space of EVs. We've kept our focus to say, let's go out there and put electric vehicles where adoption is easier and it adds value to business. But having said that, we are very clear. I think we, again, at the auto show displayed the EKUV, which is the next product that we are going to launch, and the electric version of the XUV300. So they are in store. I'm not going to give you the timelines today. I know you're looking at him and you're going to ask me that question next, but we are very clear in terms of our SUV portfolio. We will be having the electrification of many of our products.
In relation to EV here, one question. What is today the difference between India and Bharat? And you once said that the rural areas, Bharat, will drive the growth.
Bharat is what makes India's story, right? There was a time when there was an India and there was a Bharat. I think with the digital connect today, there is no India and Bharat. There is no metro, semi-urban, rural. They are classifications by income and demography. But when you come to purchase patterns, intents to purchase, aspirationals, lifestyles, the degrees change, but Bharat is where the market is. One of the advantages that we have as a brand compared to many of the other multinationals, etc., is Mahindra is known in Bharat.
Yes.
Right? Yes. Mahindra is a Bharat brand.
Your positioning there is very strong. Yes. And it kind of makes me feel happy because our country is going strong. So anyways, I want to take this now finally to that point of the conversation where we get to know you. Vijay, 25 years here at Mahindra. How do you manage to handle this amount of pressure while maintaining this amount of ease and composure?
One of the reasons why I stood with Mahindra and I'm still a part of Mahindra is exactly because of the empowerment that you are given as a leader. Your voice is heard.
Was it your first job?
Yes, it is my first job.
Oh, wow. Whoa, one sec. Do you remember your interview?
Of course I do. It's my only interview. How can I not remember it?
Were you nervous? More important.
Let me be honest. Of course, there are times when you probably are not as confident as you want to be. Mahindra was day one on campus. So you typically go through the process of group discussion, interview, all that got done. I got shortlisted. Then I had the opportunity of coming to Mahindra head office and get interviewed by a series of people. There was
no pressure.
And then the final interview obviously was with Mr. Anand Mahindra at that time.
Oh, so I went serious?
Yes. In fact, even remember a few questions from his interview. And
seriously?
I still quote them once in a while.
This is a great hack. Please, we'd love to know.
Anand asked me a question saying that If you were to be working with, it was Pepsi, I think, and let's say that a certain batch of bottles by mistake had some chemical that went in, which could lead to a problem with the consumers consuming it, what would you do? And I told him I would recall that batch totally and go out and apologize in public for the mistake that the organization has made. Who knows, maybe that was the answer to that question that probably got me to where I am today.
Good value right. system.
Right. So you take away here, don't look at salary, look at potential and of course integrity.
But he's sounding like a type A student.
I thought I was coolie number one. I was always the backbencher.
Really? You were a backbencher?
Did you ever fail a subject?
No, I did not.
I don't believe you were a backbencher. I don't believe. You were the class topper, weren't you?
No, not at all. Not at all. In fact, I've always had fun with whatever I've done. Okay, even whether it was school, whether it was college, I don't even want to tell you some of my stories. So,
camera switch up.
Fortunately, I've always known where to draw the line. Right. So I always knew that academics had a role. It was not the end all and be all for me. I enjoyed life. I made sure I did everything. But I struck a balance with my academics and I was reasonably good.
Did you think you would be at a position like this back when you were in school or college? Or
you know the cliche, right? When I was asked, where do you see yourself 5 years down
the line? Oh, I hate that
those,
question.
Those questions.
That's typically a question that you get asked in every interview. I also got asked that question. And my answer was the obvious one.
No, please do tell us. What was it?
No, well, the answer was obviously I see myself leading a business 10-15 years down the line. And fortunately, yeah, maybe not 10-15, but 25 years down the line, I've been fortunate to get to that position. You know, the lighthearted answer to that question that I normally give, I say, boss, you can always ask me 15 years down the line, what is the sales number? What is your overall volume? Agle mahine ka mat poochna.
Vijay, now that you are at the helm of it, you must have put so many teams together, successful ones. What is it that you look out for in people? What makes a brilliant mind in your books?
First thing that I look for is the energy level, passion in the person. You necessarily need not be the best in terms of your knowledge and information. In my view, that is something you can learn, you can be trained. But things like passion, working in a team, becoming a good team player, innovative and different thinking. Those who have this as an inherent nature in their DNA, that's clearly something that I look for whenever I talk to youngsters.
Do you think that I am in possession of any many of these qualities?
I think he's a damn good actor, that's for sure.
But
once you're passionate about something, then it doesn't matter. You will find success for the organization, and as a part of that, you will succeed.
I think I got my answer. I have good chances he possibly would hire me. I'm not so sure about you in that sense. We should get to understand what does a day look like for Vijay. Are you from the 4 a.m. club?
Not 4 a.m. but 5 a.m.
How does the day pan out?
I'm an early riser, irrespective of the day of the week. I have a pet who I adore. Typically wake up at 5.
Not a cat, right?
No, it's a golden retriever.
Oh, that's
take my pet for his walk, come back, morning chores at home, love my coffee in the morning, have my strong cup of coffee at 5:30, quarter to 6. And then 4 to 5 days a week, do something around fitness, either it's resistance training or just go for a long walk. And then by 8:39, jump into the day. Days are fairly long, but like I say, I'm really having fun doing what I am. Typically, day finishes around 7:30 is when I try to finish it. Maybe I have a last informal, easy conversations, which may happen from 8 to 9. Yeah, listen to some music, watch some Netflix, read a little bit, and by 10:30 off to bed.
There's a lot he's getting done, including Netflix.
So are you enjoying work from home?
I think it's a lot more productive. What I truly miss is when you were at work and you had colleagues, you could walk down the corridor, you would see people having a conversation, you would stop, say hi to someone, pat someone on the back for doing a good job. There were conversations and engagement. Now it's all on the digital space. Many a times cameras are not on, you don't know, you know, how engaged the person is in the conversation.
But one last question. We are going around doing these meetings with CEOs and MDs because we are looking for a piece of inspiration for sure. Long story short, my question is, who's your inspiration?
Frankly, when in the organization, we have some phenomenal leaders, including Mr. Anand Mahindra, I don't believe I needed to really look out. And I think he's a fantastic inspirational role model. The other one for me is Bill Gates. For them, there is a larger objective. business is a part of that larger objective of life.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Who's the tougher boss, Mr. Mahindra or Mr. Goenka?
Both of them are fantastic. It's the empowerment, right?
I don't know about them anymore.
One of the fortunate things is it's never been a relationship of a boss subordinate. It's always been a relationship where, like I said, you play an important role in creating the strategy, the execution of it. Of course, accountability lies here. There is absolutely no doubt.
I hope you won't dodge the next one. This is my final question. Don't you think the Thar looks a lot like the Wrangler?
What?
I mean, and how? I mean, what? I'm curious about how is that possible?
Because no, every SUV, an off-road SUV, since ages, has had a boxy shape. They've had rounded lamps, Jimny, G-Wagon.
But
Thar. Can I ask him, the Thar looks like G-Wagon? It does look like G-Wagon.
Okay.
There's an upcoming...
I have the answer for you guys.
Are we going somewhere?
Okay, this never happened before. Sorry guys, we're gonna have to cut and either we come back or you guys follow us.
Karthik, Rohan, herein lies your answer. Timeless Mahindra, a 300 page book, the Bible about the history of Mahindra, the DNA. So Timeless Mahindra defines the entire journey of Mahindra, and you will see that the debate that we keep happening about on the design of this vehicle, the history goes back to the 1940s, right from CJ, MM, Classic, then the Thar, and now the all new Thar. There is a history of the evolution of the design of the vehicle.
You got your answer, I get the book.
Belt up,
yeah.
And we are good to go. Let's
yes.
go.
Yes. Vijay sir, now that we are in a car, which is the Thar, tell us about the most memorable road trip that you have had.
I think one of my most memorable ones was 2009. Just come back from South Africa.
Oh, wow.
And I came back as the zonal head for West India. And to get a deep understanding of the market, I did a road trip of Madhya Pradesh. Started from Ratlam, drove through entire MP all the way to Jabalpur. And I did that in a Bolero, Scorpio. We had just launched the Thar. So a combination of these three vehicles is what I used for my road trip. And I went into the interiors of MP and it was just amazing. That Trust me, you spoke understand. About Bharat. If you want to learn Bharat, that's how you need to do it.
All right, so it's time for rapid fire questions. I'm gonna go with the first one, looks or performance?
Tough one, Thar gives you both, I love both.
Such a
if I have to choose, it's gonna be performance.
Two-wheel drive or all-wheel drive?
All-wheel drive. That was an easy one.
Books or movies?
Books.
Everybody doesn't know we are on a test track. So
rapid fire questions on the Rumblers. Sachin or Sehwag?
Tough one, Sehwag.
Okay, and this is really important, please. Karthik or Rohan?
Oh, come on, guys.
Please.
Really?
Please.
I think I'm going to give that to Rohan.
Oh, yeah. That he picks, so that he does it both. I'll take Rohan, man.
Okay, I've got a question for you. Three-door Thar or five-door Thar?
Three-door Thar.
Scorpio or XUV?
Look, right. This is a sentimental, emotional question. For me, it's Scorpio because I've been, as I said, a part of the team that created it. So.
What would be one concluding line about the Thar?
It's just a phrase. Go explore.
Well, that would be it. Thanks a lot for giving us your time. This has been one of the best interviews of my life. I hope you like it when you see it.
Thank you, Karthik. Thank you, Rohan. Loved the conversation with you guys.
Look forward to the next one.
Well, you can get in on the secret of the Thar's design DNA with this book right here. We've got two of them to give away. So you can win one by commenting below and letting us know when does Thar's history reach back to